So I'm preparing food, our meal tonight, because we've not got transport now, so we haven't been able to go to the supermarket. So this is what Mel and I are going to have. We've got water, just need hot water for that, and we'll share that with some of this bread from a few days ago, rye bread that we will cut and toast, make toast with that. And we've got a pepper that will give us some veg, you know, sort of not veg salad-y type stuff. And Sid will have this rice, which I can boil, and also on the top I've got like a steamer, so I can boil that in its packet, and then I can have this. I've been looking in the cupboards to see what we have left, and yeah, there are some peas. Don't fancy peas, but I will do the sweet corn with it. What else have we got there? We've got shortbread, we've got sauce, we've got tomato ketchup, we've got a couple of soups, we've got some more rice, and we've got some baked beans there. Yeah, it'll get a bit desperate if we can't get to the shops tomorrow, but we should be all right today. Oh, and we have half, just remembered, we've got half a rhubarb pie there from yesterday, so we can heat that up again, so we'll be all right, we won't starve.
Being without a car in a remote place is one of the things you fear most. We couldn't really do much. We went into town to get provisions. That was the priority. But we did find a really nice coffee shop and treated ourselves while we were there.
We've got some provisions, hopefully, for the next couple of days. Rucksacks full there. And we're just waiting for the taxi to take us back.
It's not raining,
this is a mercy. And there's also this lovely little seating area that you can sit in, which is just lovely. And so and the sun's shining, so it's all good. And so far the car's in the garage still, just waiting to find out what's wrong with it. Just wondering whether we're going to get a hire car, because we definitely need one. Can you hear the music from your kids? So hopefully we'll be back soon. And hopefully we'll have transport before too long.
When you picked her back, there's so different tuning to.
It was just a waiting game, waiting for the garage to tell us what was wrong with the car, and they didn't get it on the ramp for the first day, so we were just hanging around in limbo, really. Dennis seemed to be picking up a signal with the CAT scanner to indicate that there was already electricity to the house. So we arranged for an electrician to come round the following Tuesday just to see if it could be made safe for us to use even temporarily for the purpose of the build. But when Brian, the electrician, came, he said
that the supply was very low and it couldn't be used now, so we had to go back to plan A, have a new line fitted. An interim supply, which means he'd only put a few sockets and a few light switches in the house, which would be connected to a consumer unit, and that would then have a box fitted on the outside of the house where ESB would come and lay in a new 16 amp supply to the house.
So we're just walking up to Maggie's again to put our stew on. We've got a nice chicken stew there. Let's have a look.
Lovely view today. The sun is out. Look at that blue sky.
From gigs,
thanks, Maggie.
TV appearances, the whole lot. And same goes for the next band. You would forget how huge they are.
We'll
not just
in about 3 hours. Okay.
On a global scale, they'll actually be touring all over Asia in September and October and places like Singapore.
Nell spotted this plaque on the wall, an Irish blessing. As you slide down the banister of life, may the splinters never point the wrong way.
Security lock.
Here we are approaching our driveway. Can you see how the road changes into that newer road? I love that road. That's it, every time I walk on it. I love this road. And I think it just looks so smart. Now, and then as we come round, you can see the little house. The little hidden house, little white house there, hidden. Well, at the bottom of the lane. So you remember earlier we went to Maggie's to put the slow cooker on for our tea. It's now 6:30, we're getting hungry, we know that tea will be ready. So we're going to collect the slow cooker, but we've got to get beyond that fence to get our dinner. So it might be a bit of a challenge. Are we going to do it? No.
Come on.
Off you go.
Go ahead.
Just be commanding. Speak with authority. That's it. Good girls.
Good girls.
That hurt my ears. Okay. Good luck. I'll see you later. Aren't they lovely? I think they seem very gentle. It's Monday evening. We don't know anything about what's happening with the car. They've taken it. It was delivered to the Ford garage in Tralee this morning about lunchtime, and they need to get it on the diagnostic to see what's the matter with it. So we're left without any transport. We had to go into town to get some food. We had nothing left. And so we had to get a taxi, and the taxi was €25 to get us to town. It's about 7 miles away, is it? Something like that. And then, of course, €25 back. So it cost us €50 to get about €30 worth of shopping. And of course, we couldn't get more, simply because we can't carry a lot more. But also because we don't have a fridge, so you're limited in what you can get. You know, you get your milk and stuff that needs the fridge, mainly milk. And what we're doing is just keeping it in a bottle outside at night. It's great when it rains because everything really cools down, and the water in the container, that like if you put it in like a little bucket, then it acts as a sort of fridge. So that's been okay so far, but it's just that not knowing what is going to happen. Because they must just be busy, so they're not giving us an answer, even though we're ringing. So let's just wait and see what tomorrow brings. It can be quite scary. It makes you realise that there is a risk to being remote. And I think one thing that we know we will do is always have like an old car, but maybe a motorbike or something in the garage, in the shed, just extra backup if you ever need it. So that you're not stranded and relying on either the kindness of others. Unfortunately, Willie couldn't
give us a lift. They offered me a lift on Sunday night, quite late, and I said, oh no, because there won't be any shops open. It would have just been like one of those 24/7 shops. So I thought, well, wait till Monday when I know that like Lidl and Aldi are open. But they were around all day, so they couldn't help us out. So we did get there, but it wasn't great. We were waiting for about half an hour, and it was showering on and off and got absolutely drenched. We waited at the bottom of the lane for the taxi to come. But we've got enough food, and we'll wait and see if we find out tomorrow. I was thinking, what happens if it's something really big and they can't fix it? What happens if it costs more to repair it than the car's worth and we have to just get another car? That'd be it'd have an Irish registration plate. How do we get back with an Irish car in terms of the insurance and everything? I just, you know, my mind just starts to create problems. And hopefully, you know, there is also the alternative outcome that it's just something small and it's easily fixed. But it's that waiting, because they haven't had time to put it on the diagnostic machine. So it's just, we're in a bit of limbo at the moment and just having to manage the anxiety.
Here we are, bringing back the food to the encampment. About 7 o'clock. And we get that lovely slow cooker stew.
What is it? Oh, have you made a little bridge?
a little bridge.
A little thing for carrying water. What do you? Oh,
well, I don't know. I don't know where it's for. Really.
What, with buckets on either side?
Well, I don't know. Probably more for.
Yeah.
No, for maybe for towing about, tethered it to a horse or something. Or a
cat. It's really sort of like nursery rhyme stuff, isn't it? You know, the sort of things you see in like children's books.
Funny old thing.
From the garage.
Hopefully.
I hope so, said I'm so worried.
Hello? Yeah? Oh, that's great news. Well done. Thank you.
Noel and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water, except it's just Jill today. But thankfully, it'll be the last time we have to do this, because we're getting the car back. We've had good news from the garage. They found out what it was. It was just something electrical. It wasn't a mechanical problem. And it hasn't cost too much money. So it's been really hard being without a car for the last 2 days. 3 days? Yes, and Sunday, we're on Wednesday now. And it's just been a real lesson in the fact that you're so remote out here. How much we rely on them. And we've had to be resourceful. So we have been going and collecting water on foot to the next house where there's a water pump, which is about a mile away. But from now on, we can drive the car up here. But these things, you know, you learn from them and you appreciate things a little bit more. And it's something to celebrate today. Got a car back, got wheels. No radio today. Why is the radio not on? We're just here in front of Worth. We're going to try and get cable for a generator, because we've got the offer of a generator. So because we're in Tralee picking the car up, we're going to go and see if we can just get what else we need and hopefully get sorted with electricity. Okay, we've got the car and look, washing up liquid.
Very good.
Clothes and tea towels.
Wow, tea towels.
How long do you think they'll stay like that?
30 seconds.
I dare bring them into the caravan. Mm. And chips.
Very
and
good.
And a chair so we can all sit down.
Got a three-man chair. This season, I will mostly be wearing Christian Dior. I know he was just rubbish all the time. There's a big sheet of plastic here that might be worth cutting.